I'm Gio Fitzpatrick, and I'm the Youth Wildlife Ambassador. On a broader scale, in Australia, huge amounts of habitat has either been lost entirely or heavily modified. So, originally in woodlands in southeastern Australia, there would have been 17 hollow-bearing trees per hectare on average. A hollow-bearing tree, say a big old river red gum, might have 10 or more hollows in it of all different shapes and sizes. And a huge portion of our birds and mammals in particular have become so specialised that they will only breed in tree hollows, and that's worked very well for them for the last roughly 14 million years, ever since Australia sort of dried out and became mostly woodland. So there's this really sudden change when you put a city and you put farms all over the landscape, and it's such a fast change that there's no way that you could expect wildlife to adapt to that. So what we can do in the short term is put up nesting boxes in some places, and also, more importantly, try to replant as much of what's been lost as possible. The great thing about nest boxes, though, is, as I was saying, they sort of allow people to connect with nature in a meaningful way. So not only they're sort of a direct conservation benefit, but also they are probably more broadly so as well, because often in cities people are pretty isolated from wildlife and they don't think about biodiversity or the environment in their daily lives. So I visited the Elster Creek area first about 5 years ago. And that's that. The Elster Creek runs through Brighton and Elwood, I visited one day on my bike with my dog, and I was just sort of exploring, and I heard this interesting call, and I looked up, and there were maybe three or four eastern rosellas that flew over me, and I just couldn't believe my eyes. So living in St Kilda, they have sort of become locally extinct in this area. And just a short bike ride away, there was this little population that I didn't really know about. So I thought, what a special place. These parrots are still surviving here when in all the other areas surrounding it, they've sort of dropped out. And the more I visited, I realised it was the case for lots of different species. So the Elster Creek area, I decided to make a special study of it. And I also set up a group called the Friends of Elster Creek, and their main aim was preventing the local extinction of certain animal species, and there was a big focus on the eastern rosellas. And that was when I started doing a lot of research into hollows for them, and I was actually going around surveying all the hollows through the spring to try and find out where they were nesting, and I was talking to local naturalists, and it turned out they hadn't been recorded nesting for probably the last 10 years or so. And rosellas don't live much longer than 10 years, so I realised I had this very narrow window of time to actually provide nesting sites for them. And every hollow that I checked in the area, even though there are already very few, they were all occupied by the very abundant ring-tailed possums or brush-tailed possums as well, or introduced Indian miners and things like that. So I decided to put up nesting boxes for the rosellas, and very quickly they were occupied by the same animals as all of the hollows, and it took me 5 years, so it was up until 2016, so last year, that I eventually came up with a design. It was a very funny looking box. It's about a metre and a half tall, very narrow, with a sloping lid, all these interesting kind of design features which I had to, by trial and error, eventually find would stop things like possums getting in and Indian minor birds and things like that. And it was that box, that really tall, funny-looking box, that in October last year the eastern rosellas finally managed to move into. And they raised 6 chicks, which are all now flying free in the Elster Creek area, and I still see them occasionally. You can recognise the youngsters by their more pointed tail feathers and more greeny coloured backs and things like that. So it's really quite special to see them flying around. There was only maybe a population of about 12 or so. So to pump another six young ones into that population is very exciting for me. So hoping to do the same this spring.
Awesome.
Cool.
You're not still freezing.
Oh, no, I'm all right now. I'm in the sun, so...